Right, here we go. A little sneaky rod. It's down on my little outlet spot. Foolishly, no bobbin. And because the fluorocarbon was proper slack, we picked a little beep up, and I've got to the rod and the line's just tightening up, and it wasn't out the clip, and it just pinged out the clip as I've looked down. So we've got a carp on. I came up yesterday and just trickled a couple of kilo. There was quite a bit of weed around this, and I baited all that sort of dam end. We didn't think we'd get a bite because our friendly little pony has just had a bit of a hissy fit and ran straight across the dam over all the bricks. But we've got a bite, and this time seems, within an hour of getting it, it seems to be quite consistent for getting a bite. This is the third time now that I've had a bite within probably an hour or so of putting the rods out. And I'm a bit nervous because it is quite cold. Here it is. We don't want him going up that shelf. You can see by the colour of the water, when I came to bait up, and I thought they were either really troughing, but then we've had quite a bit of rain around this area. Now obviously, it's a mirror. There's loads of commons in it, this is a mirror. And obviously all the water's coming in off the fields, and I did wonder whether that sort of would have knocked them. Here we go, get him in that net. Oh yes, cool. It's only a mirror. It's a mirror from the Commons Lake. How good is that? There's 10 ton of weed, but there's a mirror carp in there. So I'll warm my hands up on the stove, be good with, and then we'll get him out and we'll hold him up. That's a proper result because it's absolutely Baltic. He could well be a 20 pounder, him. Right, just before we take the hook out, just look where that is. Oh, my hands are so cold. Right, okay. What have we got?
Give you 22.
22?
22, mate.
That'll do me. That is a proper nice little lump for the winter. Alright, there we go. 22 pound of winter gnarly old character. My hands are absolutely like blocks of ice, but look at him, he's been proper through the mill. He's got a slightly twisted section on his top off, but look at his tail. Really big old paddle. And I suppose if the water temperature wasn't so cold, he probably would have scrapped a bit more. But he's no match for the tong, so I give him a bit of brute force just to get him in. But little play around with rigs at the minute, and I've been trying a rig that I've wanted to try for quite a few years called the multi-rig. And even though I've been feeding Monster Tiger Nut, I caught him on a white source pop-up. So again, continuing the theme of what I use for most of my fishing, which is fishing a bright pop-up over an unmatched food source. And it seems to work. So what we'll do is we'll slip him back, because I'm sure it's a damn sight warmer under the water than it is out. And then we'll go through the rig that I managed to fool him on. But absolutely over the moon with that, absolute belter. Proper twisted by his head, isn't he? We're just going to talk through the rig that I had that lovely gnarly old mirror on, and it's a bit of a change for me. Not only you'll notice that I know I'm getting very old age and have to wear spectacles for certain aspects of my fishing, hence they're now on when I have to look at things close up, but it makes quite a refreshing change for me to talk about any other rig rather than a choddy or a hinge stiff or a solid bag, and they catch me hundreds of carp. But there's a rig I've been dying to use for a good few years now. I've never actually found the right situation, which is the multi-rig. Some people call it the Johnny Matt rig. Johnny Matt used it extensively, but I do believe it was Mickey Kavanagh whose original concept come up with what's known as the multi-rig. Now, on tuitions, people use this and they show it me in the margins, and it looks absolutely fantastic in the margins, but in a weedy situation, you know, I always go back to a solid bag or a chod on the basis that, in my opinion, in weed they are without doubt the best source of a presentation. But the lake I'm fishing now, there's hardly any weed in whatsoever. You get a very good drop literally everywhere you cast in the deeper water, so I thought, why not try the multi-rig? You know, it's middle of winter. And it's already got me all the bites bar one. I did use the choddy on the first trip, but then when I sort of dug around a bit deeper and realised the bottom wasn't, you know, you didn't really need to use a choddy, to be honest, so I thought I'll try the multi-rig. And I've put quite a few pictures on Facebook, and, you know, Matt's got some footage of the hook holds that this has had, and the multi-rig users out there will verify that it absolutely nails them. Now, this is my version of it. And what I did try the first time I used it a few weeks ago was on the tag end. I tried to put the shot on there and it worked and I caught, but I now, I've spoken to Julian Cundiff again, he massively rates the multi-rig, and he suggested putting the shot on the section where you peel the coating back to give it the hinge so that the pop-up sits, you know, on a hinge system. And I like that, and I've looked at it in the margins, and I just, that's the one for me. So the shot, as you can see, so basically all you've got, mine are quite long, again, running along the theory of that I like long rigs. So this is quite a stiff coated braid, and it's just got a figure of eight loop knot, both ends. Really, really simple to tie. You don't even have to tie a new hook link every time you have a fish, because you can quite easily change the hook. You know, it's just a case of threading the loop section by the hook through the eye, putting your pop-up peg on, and then obviously over the hook, and you're away. You know, it's so simple, it's so quick. I can understand why people really, really rate it. Now, on that, you've got a little 10 mil source white pop-up. I've been catching on those and the Pink Crave, again, 10 mil. And you can see, it basically sits, I'll just keep that up in the frame. That's how it sits on the bottom. So you can see the hinge and the shot. It still gives me the option to use pop-ups, which I do for most of my fishing. But I really like the way it sits. I like the speed of it, that you can change your hook. And some people, I think, will look at this and think, well, all that's technically holding the fish on is the fact that when that loop pulls down during the fight, the loop pulls against the eye of the hook. Well, it doesn't come over that, because it's so tight and you've got the ridge where the weld of the hook is. I think that's what keeps it in place. And people that have used this rig a lot more than me and had very, very big fish on this rig and not lost them because of that reason. So all I have is, I have a little silicone sleeve just covering, because there's a quick link under there to make taking the rig on and off should I need to a lot quicker. I have a couple of blobs of putty to keep everything pinned down. That is a BB shot. That is a size 5 stiff rig razor point hook. Now again, I've spoke to Julian about this, and he likes to use a curved style hook. And one of the other rods I've actually got out today, that's got an MSC, which is an ace hook, and that's a medium shank curve. So it's quite a longer, not quite a series 5 stroke long shank nailer hook that used to be kind of very much frowned upon, slightly shorter shank, and I do like that it sits more like a claw. But I'm going to play around with the curves, because I think I could like how the loop sits over the back of it, so again it makes the pop-up sit like a claw, basically like that. Now, another thing that I like about this rig is you can tie the loop quite small, so when you put the loop over the hook to give you the D, the longer the loop, obviously the higher up you're going to have your pop-up off the deck. Now I like that, how I've tied it, because it's a very small loop, which means I can have the shot close to the knot, so the pop-up is going to be sitting very, very close to the bottom. I don't really, I mean, you know, my chods are different, but I'm going to be fishing a different style when I'm using the chod, so I'm quite happy to use a 2-2.5 inch chod in weed on the basis that I want it sitting above the weed. If I'm going to use this rig, I'm pretty much sure that there's not that much debris on the bottom. So obviously I can get away with a much smaller pop-up, so not to raise suspicion with fish that are going to potentially pick it up. So first impressions and first testing of the way I'm using it is proving very fruitful. A couple of 20 pounders, a couple of mid to upper doubles in savage conditions. So you know, the water I'm fishing isn't rock hard at all. There's plenty of fish in, it's a good winter water. So I thought it would be a good place to start testing, start using it and getting my confidence up in it. And it's certainly a rig, I'm already thinking there's waters I know where there is clearer areas where this rig would suit. And as much as I advocate using the Chod in a lot of situations in the stiff inch rig, they're very much the fashionable rigs these days. Everybody's using them. They used to be a massive edge 5-6 years ago. Now they're not so much of an edge because everybody uses them. So I think people are now looking for alternative rigs to sort of either go back to or look to progress to. And this, I think, is one of those rigs that can easily get forgotten, much like a pretty standard bottom bait rig. But the problem with a bottom bait rig is that it's got to be, in my opinion, crystal clear to present. So even if there's a bit of sort of debris on the bottom, like I've just mentioned, this is a very stiff coated uplink. So on a clear bottom, it's got to fall away and sit lovely. You probably wouldn't want something this stiff where there's a bit of debris, bit of leaf matter, slightly bits of silkweed, but you could easily play around with the weighting system of whichever size pop-up you're going to use, so that once you've cast out, I would foam it up and then it's just going to come down very slowly and sit on top of the weed. So it's quite versatile. There's going to be lots of variations what people do or do not do. Some people will prefer putting the shot on the tag. I, just looking at it now and the way it sits in the on the bottom, I like the fact that the shot is keeping most of it neat, you know, apart from there's a little bit of coating where you can see it's peeled back. I'm sort of brimming with confidence, if you like. There's other waters I want to go on that I think, well, this will work. You can almost picture in your head where you would want to put it and where you would catch fish from on something other than the latest phase rigs, you know. So that is the multi-rig. There's lots of ways to tie it on YouTube and various sort of Facebook outlets. It's very, very easy to tie. There's not even a knot, it's just two loop knots and away you go. I would say that make sure you steam it, play around with your different coated braids to find out which one will suit you for your fishing situation. And it's certainly a rig that's going to feature quite massively in my fishing for next year. Again, the colour is quite important. Like I say, pinks, whites, you don't have to change the colour of hook bait that you use. You know, if you want to use a matching food bait to whatever you're feeding, you can do that. It's so versatile that there's loads and loads of different ways of fishing it. So that is my take on the multi-rig, and it's working for me, and I'm very, very happy that I've changed to it after all these years of thinking about it.